In this session, we are going to start the discussion about circulation module. In circulation module, there are 7 options. The first one is member categories, subcategories, member registration, issue and reserve, return and renew, circulation transaction, and generate overdue notice. All these are linked with each other. To start the issue return, first we have to create the member category and then we have to create the subcategories. Based on member categories and subcategories, we can create the member record. And using the member record, we can issue and reserve the item. If any book is issued, then we can return using this option. And whatever the books have been issued or whatever the books have been returned by user, we can generate the report using this circulation transaction. If we want to generate the overdue notice to individual member, we can use this option. So all these options are linked with each other. So let us start from the member categories. Just click on member categories, and to create the new member, just click on add new. But before clicking on add new, you have to ensure that how many categories you are going to create. For example, in case of Kendri Vidyalaya, we are having 3 type of users. The first one is the staff, the second one is students, and third one is primary. Primary means the class library. Issue the books to class libraries. So to create, we can see here in the database, 3 group names have been created already. To create a new member category, just click on add new. You can see this text box is highlighted where you can enter the name of the category or group. And below the text box, there is HOD text box where you can enter the detail. And finally, you can click on save. So as soon as you click on save, it will be saved in the category list. The same way, we can create these subcategories. In subcategories or designation, we create the different subcategories. Let us take the example of Kendri Vidyalayas. As we created the category, 3 categories, staff, student, and primary. So under this, let us take the first one. This we have created for teaching staff, that will come under staff, non-teaching and teaching staff. Class library we have created for issuing the books to class libraries, and this subcategory we have created for individual class. Just come to the next option, that is member registration. This is very important. To create the new member record, just click on member registration. It will open a window where we can create the new member record. To create the new member record, just click on Add New. It will open and highlight the areas where you have to enter the detail of the member. Suppose you are going to create a member for class 6 student, then you have to give here the member name, member number. For example, the admission number of a student is 9876. Second option is category. In which category you are going to create this member? You can enter the residential address here. After that, you just give the email ID of the student or the member. Then you enter the phone number of the member, then gender. You can select the gender here, and this option check yes or no. If you check no, the privilege for issuing the book, suppose you have fixed that this student or this member can take 2 books from library. In case the member has already taken 2 books and the member wants one more book from library, if you check the S option, the software will allow to issue one more book to him. But if you have selected no, in that case the member will not be allowed by the software to take the book after the maximum limit is over. Now enter the name of the user. For example, username is user or any name. Subcategory, select the subcategory. For example, you are creating the member for class 6A. Select the subcategory and enter the address of KV. You can enter the age here, and you can enter the final closing date. When is the it has to be decided by you when you are going to fix the closing date. For example, 31st March 2014, and click on Save button. As soon as you click on Save button, you can see that the member is added to the list of users. Once again, you select this option and go to Edit. Once again, this option will be highlighted, where you can give the other detail also. Just click on Other Detail tab. Here you can give remark. Here you can give subject of the user. For example, you are creating the member for any staff and the staff is interested in his subject or her subject. So if you select the subject, the user can see the means his specific subject detail in OPAC in his own account. Finally, you can see here the status. If you want to, you have closed the member, then you can select the closed, or if you have cancelled the membership of the user, you can select this cancelled option. By default it will be current. If the user goes on TC, or you have to issue the no due certificate, you can enter the date of no due certificate here. And reason for close or cancellation, you can give the detail here. Now there is one more option which is highlighted, that is reset password. You can give the password to the particular user so that user can see his or her detail in online public access catalog, that how many books he or she has taken from library and when is the due date to return the book in library. Then you have to give the password. It should be minimum 10 digit alphanumeric password. This is not compulsory, you can give either alphabet or numeric also, but it should not be less than 10 digit password. Just click on S, member password reset successfully, OK, and click on exit. Finally, update the record. So in this way we have created one member ID. The member number is 9876 and name of the user is user. Suppose you want to print the member card, in that case you have to click on this option, print card. You can see it is showing the member card which can be printed on the label, or member card can be printed on your desired paper. See, the user which we have created just now, is detail is given here. This member card after printing can be given to a student for circulation purpose. So in this way we can generate the membership of any new user. We can see also the detail report, summary report. We can delete the member, we can edit the member from this window. So hope this will be very useful, how we can create the membership using circulation and membership registration options.